Hi, YouTube family and friends. I hope everybody is staying safe and nobody is sick. I know this has affected us all in a lot of different ways. Being stuck at home, we finally got here in Virginia, finally got the lockdown notice that we are only allowed to leave our homes for essential things like gas, food, and if you have to go to the doctor or pick up a prescription. Most doctors aren't even open. Anyways, what I thought I would do is, obviously since we can't dumpster dive anymore, do a little bit of some stuff that I have gotten in the past. I started dumpster diving before I actually joined YouTube in with a dumpster diving channel. So I have stuff that nobody's ever really seen before. Our plans were to get stuff and start flea marketing. And actually, our first flea market was supposed to be this Saturday. I do have a lot of stuff organized that we were going to take. Some stuff you've seen, some stuff you haven't. But I thought I would just give you a glimpse of some of the stuff that I have gotten in the past, which it's all over the house. And this time that I'm going to be having off, which will probably extend past the 2 weeks I was told I would be off of work. Thank goodness I'm able to collect unemployment. So that's a good thing. You can probably see behind me boxes and that. There are, like I said, it's everywhere. So this is going to give me ample time to be able to organize and sort and get stuff put into storage that could be for different holidays and stuff. A lot of that I've already done as it came in. I found it Christmas, Thanksgiving, Halloween, but there's still stuff that straggled in that I have to get over to our trailer next door. I'm going to start in the back bedroom that used to be my boyfriend's mama's room. She has passed away and we have been living in her house. But a lot of the stuff that you see in there is actually our personal stuff boxed up because, make a long story short, his brother and sister and him own this house. His brother and sister want to sell it. He can't afford to buy them out, so it'll eventually be sold. So we have a lot of our stuff that we're not using boxed up. But there is a few things in there that I do want to show you. So I guess what I'm going to do is just start in that room and just kind of come forward this way a little bit and show you a few of the things that I have found. I also have stuff out in our fifth wheel RV trailer that we have that I'm not going to do today. I'll do that in another video. I also want to do a couple other videos of putting together maybe the two baby cribs that I found, and we also found another item. I'm not going to spoil the surprise, but finishing putting that together. And one last thing before I start showing some of this stuff, I really want to get more subscribers, and I'm sure everybody does. And what I want to do is when I reach my 100th subscriber, I'm going to do a big giveaway. And this giveaway will probably, I'm going to say it's probably going to be somewhere between $50, $60. But what I'm going to do, it could even be more, what I'm going to let people choose. I've decided to do, when you do it, you have to obviously like my video, comment when, you know, that you want to win, and then I'm going to give you some options of what you could win, and then you can put it on there. Like, I'm going to do a spa. I have, in fact, I'll actually show you. It was one of the Christmas things. It is a pedicure manicure full set. I'm not 100% sure of the price. The tag is not on there, but I would assume it was around for Christmas. There's a pair of slippers. There's fingernail polishes. There's a scrub. There's one of those things for your nails. There's nail filers. There's a foot buffer. There's a toenail, a nail clipper set. There are creams, lotions. This thing had to be, and the basket that it comes in, had to be obviously around $50, $60. I have no idea. Anyways, this will be like the spa one that I give away. I'm also going to give away, well, you can comment either spa, pet. I have a ton of pet stuff like harnesses, leashes, not so much leashes, harnesses, a few leashes. I have collars, costumes, doggy costumes with and without harnesses. So there'll be a pet one. There's also going to be a kid one. And the kid one, obviously, you'd have to let me know if it's a boy or a girl and their ages or both, so I can, you know, put a little bit of both. I have tons of kids' toys, crafts, blah, blah, blah. Also, there'll be a craft one, and you'll have to let me know if you like to paint, colored pencils, markers, sewing kits. I have a lot of that stuff. So, with that being said, once I reach the 100 mark, I'm going to do a big giveaway. And like I said, it'll probably be worth roughly, it could be upwards of $50, $60. So please like, share, and, you know, subscribe to my channel. And that'll be another one of the stipulations. You'll have to be subscribed. Get your friends to subscribe. You know, if they just want to subscribe just to get on this drawing, that's fine with me. But the more people I can get, the faster I can get to giving this giveaway. So anyways, and I also just wanted to tell you a little bit about myself. My name's Michelle. I'm 59 years old. Never in my life at this age did I think I would be dumpster diving. But it is what it is. I'm doing this to supplement my income. My boyfriend is disabled and he's on SSDI. He does not get a lot of money. I do work full time, obviously not now. I'm going into my 21st year of running an industrial embroidery machine. I love it. I absolutely love it. I don't go to work and not like my job. I love running an embroidery machine. And when I say an embroidery machine, it's like if your company wants their logo embroidered on a shirt or a hat or whatever, that's what I do. And I've done it, like I said, going on 21 years, and I love my job. I also love my part-time job, dumpster diving. So with all that being said, oh, one last thing. I have two children. One lives in Texas, my son, and one lives in Indiana. I am in Virginia. I'm originally from Michigan. All my family and friends are in Michigan, except for my two kids, obviously. And I have a six-month-old first granddaughter, Remy Jo. Miss her. Was supposed to have a trip in a couple of weeks to Texas with my daughter, actually. We were going to all meet there in Texas and spend a few days with the grandbaby. That's probably not going to happen. And it's heartbreaking for me because my son does FaceTime with me. In fact, he FaceTimed this morning, and she's growing up so fast, and I'm missing so much. I thank God that her other grandma and grandpa are able to see her every day. Yes, am I jealous? Yes, I'm very jealous. I don't get to see her enough. I've actually only seen her twice, the day she was born and Christmas. So I'm missing it. It's hard. It's very hard being away. So with that being said, that's a little bit about me. I am going to grab the tripod and turn you around, and we're going to walk into the back bedroom so I can show you a few things. Please, don't mind the house. It is a disaster, but part of this being off, this is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to turn you around. You won't see me anymore. You'll see just the stuff. Okay, empty box in the way, first of all. Okay, here we go into the back bedroom. Like I said, don't mind the bedroom. Most of this stuff is our personal stuff. Don't freak out thinking, oh my God, she's a hoarder. I'm not a hoarder. This is all my personal stuff boxed up. A few things we have found. You did see these bins are already, we're ready to go to the flea market. It's filled with the stuff that I found at Dollar General, and I do have a video out there on that. The main thing I really wanted to show you in here was these that I found. They're called Squishmallows. They're a 16-inch. Well, this one's obviously a unicorn, but they're like a pillow, a really squishy foam pillow, and they come back like a memory foam pillow. There's also this one, which is the dinosaur. And as you can see, I'm going to pan over here. I have put them all back here because I just did not have any other room for them. This room is not for the stuff that I have gotten out of the dumpster. There's a mermaid one. This one is a bird. More than unicorns. And also, there's bags down underneath. I'm not pulling them all out. Total, I found 33 of these Squishmallows. And I absolutely love this guy. Whoops. Let me back up. This big dinosaur. And there's also a purple unicorn the same size as him. I'm just not 100% positive where that one is. And like I said, I'm not going to dig, but you can see. So I found a total of 41 altogether of these. I have had people all over asking me if I can ship them, and I have no problem shipping. I don't offer shipping because it's so expensive. To ship one of these, I was able to, it's only 2.5 pounds, but I was able to squish it into a $15 priority box. So that's what it's going to be. I'm selling them for $10. They're normally $20. These are all brand new. You can see they're still in the sealed plastic bags, which was also in boxes, but we couldn't fit all the boxes in our Jeep. So I'm selling them for $10, but if you wanted them for $15 for shipping, it's more than what they originally cost. Now, from what I understand, some of these are not even being made anymore. They've come out with new ones. Also, I went to ship a package of two, and it was almost $30. There's a lion. Oh, and these are all going to fall over, which is fine. But like I said, this room is not, it's not my dumpster diving stuff. This is my personal stuff. There's a few things in here just to get it in here. This was a luxury comfort pillow top mattress pad. We did find that. And that bottle of aloe was found, which I'm actually going to make hand sanitizer with that. I found out how to do that. I'm going to make hand sanitizer with that. There's a couple of other things in here, but nothing that great. And like I said, excuse the mess, excuse this house. This was a very old house, and his mama never put any money into renovating it. So here's some other stuff. Well, let's start over here. A couple of frames. The glass is still good. The corners on them were cracked, and I fixed them. So there's 2 8x10 frames. There is a, which we are keeping because we camp, and also this little thing, Coleman, we found that. I don't think there's anything in that. I found a nice candy thermometer, or whatever you need to use a thermometer for. A lot of people, this would be like, I would use it for a candy thermometer. This is just one of the things that I found. It's a flat iron, I believe. Yeah, it's a flat iron. It's for wet and dry. I found that. Some coffee that I found somewhere. I have no idea where I found it. Nothing wrong with it. And this is a bunch of tester oils. Orange spice. 100% essential oils. This is all oils. And I believe I found this, and then, yeah, I did, in Bed Bath and Beyond, along with the thing that I put them in. Also, coming over here, this was just the other day out of Aldi. I don't get much out of, I don't really do Aldi a lot, but, because I never really find anything. These are like, and they're not even expired, April something. Strawberry Banana Fruit Bar, low fat. This one is a apple carrot hemp seed bar. Just grabbed a bunch of those. This was something I pulled out of Marshall's. It's a very heavy marble tray or cutting board or whatever you want to use it for. That was with my Christmas haul. I can't show you all that stuff because it's packed away in the trailer. Also out of the Aldi, 2 boxes of apple and cherry pies that had just expired that day that we pulled them out. It's 3/29 is the date on them. So that is something else we got. I found this propane torch kit in a dumpster, and it's all there. I also pulled this and Mr. Heater. It's a heater, obviously. Mr. Heater is a heater. It's a propane heater. Thank you, Kevin. And pulled this out of the dumpster. It wasn't working when we got it. Kevin took it apart, put it back together, and it works just fine.
I came out of a dumpster.
Kevin just said he came out of a dumpster. No, he didn't. I found all this, and this is wonderful. This is coffee. It expired. I think it's at Best Buy the 15th.
You care for a cup?
Big deal. Do I care for a cup? I have a cup. Thank you, honey. Okay, you make you a cup. Thank you so much. 10 of them. Kevin had already pulled one out and is using it. We both love it. We both love dark roast coffee. But there is 10 of these all together. Y'all, excuse my pillows. And no, that's not a bug. It's a feather coming out of the pillow. There's 10 of these. Why I'm pulling them out is I want to show you the other stuff. This came out of a Do you remember the name of that bookstore? Or that bookstore? Was it Million Books or something? Anyway, some bookstore. What? No. It was some bookstore that I'd never even heard of before. Anyways, there's 10 of those. Also, what came out of that same bookstore. And let me find that bag. I actually found this bag in a wine shop dumpster. They must order from Chick-fil-A. But I love, look at the size of that bag. I love it. These also, I'm not pulling them all out. I will pull a couple of them out. These are from a company called Sweet Shop. And they are chocolate almond toffee, dark and milk chocolate. There is also a package. Where is one of them? Those are the toffees. Oh, here we go. From the Sweet Shop. These are chocolate covered caramel squares, dark and milk chocolate. There was also a bunch of Kind protein bars in there. Different kinds. This is white chocolate, cinnamon, almond. Well, that's white chocolate, cinnamon, almond too. But there was different ones. This one is crunchy peanut butter. And these are all, I didn't think they were, but these are all individually wrapped inside. Sweet Shop also. This is a white chocolate Oreo bark. Now, we have eaten some of the caramels and some of the toffees. They are perfectly fine. There's nothing wrong with them. But you can see there was just these. Each one of these were in a great big white box that said expired 3/26 or something. So expiration, or not, best buy date, whatever. They're still good. There's nothing wrong with them. They're not stale. So that came out of that same dumpster. Oh, we were at Ollie's. This is hilarious because we actually need a new toilet seat, an elongated toilet seat. There's nothing wrong with it. The package is not ripped, torn. It's not broken. There is nothing wrong with it. So we're going to keep that and put that, it's heavy too, on the toilet. I found also, I don't even know what dumpster this came out of. It's a queen size, I believe, full queen duvet cover with the price of $40 on it. I'm going to wash that up. I will show you a couple things. I didn't even know what this dumpster was when I went in. Never been in it before. It was a nutrition place. These are all packages of, and you can see there was a shaker. I grabbed the shaker. But there's a bunch of packages of Hexapro Ultra Premium 6 Protein Blend. This is a cookies and cream. It's filled. And there was also some of these cinch bags in there. Some of the cinch bags that are in there, like this one, I haven't even opened it up yet. I haven't even got to it yet. There was also whatever this is, Credo Greens for athletes, gluten-free, blah, 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 chocolate flavor. I don't know what's in here, but they're, just a bunch of, like, samples of more protein stuff. This was also in that same dumpster. It is, for any of you all on low-carb diets, these are little puffs, Pro Puffs, tomato basil. There's a honey sriracha. That's a hard one to say. There was these MBP, My Protein Bites, double Dutch chocolate down here. These are a chocolate peanut butter. Grab the gold snack bar. Sure, if they're low carb, but there was also on the other side a peanut butter and jelly one. Yeah, peanut butter and jelly. That's chocolate peanut butter. So all this whole box is full of those. I'm not pulling everything out. This I went to a Walgreens that we go to. We always do really good at this Walgreens. That's where I got those stuffed animals I showed you before. So there was some Honey Grahams, Nilla wafers, bunches of gum, extra gum, Orbit. Extra, these are some Green Mountain coffee shots. A whole box of this. The box is wet, so I took this out. Your 5-Hour Energy, there's 12 of those. I don't usually do those, but those coffee shots look cool. I love Green Mountain. Also a box, bag of Skinny Pop. 5 packages of Oreo Thins. Three or four packages of oatmeal raisin. Chips, some Chips Ahoy. Their brands of Chips Ahoy cookies, and down there, two Good and Plenty's. I also believe there was a Twix bar and something else in there, but I have a homeless person that I give to, and he, I know, is definitely homeless because he He actually showed me his tent where he stays and everything. So, and he has a pit bull that he has with him all the time. So I make up packages for him and take them to him at least once a week. And I always add a bag of dog food for him in there. Let's see if there's anything. Oh, yeah. Well, come over here. This is some other stuff I'm going to put. We have to fix this, but I absolutely love this. I don't know if I showed this before, but it says, love you to the moon and back. Two of these have come unscrewed. No big deal. But I love that. It's so cute. I love that kind of stuff. Oh, also in the back, this was just from one haul from a couple of different places. Michael's, Bath and Body Works. I mean, I have three other boxes just like this. This one, I'm not going to pull everything out, but this was a really, may your troubles be less and your blessings be more and nothing but happiness come through your door. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Perfect message for right now, too. This is just some odds and ends that I have, this, like I said, Halloween, it's a Halloween kit. Odds and ends that I have picked up. These are some Airborne, probably from CVS or something. Bunch of really pretty cards that I pulled out of a Hallmark store. I mean, these cards, $7. I don't know if you can see it. $7.99 for this one card. But they're absolutely beautiful. I only picked, there was hundreds of them. I only got the ones that were in the packages like that so that they would stay nice. Let's see what else we got. A lantern that we picked up. We have to, I don't think we're going to replace all the glass. I might just set it out and put a candle in it. No, my sewing machine down there is not something I pulled out of the dumpster. That is actually my sewing machine. This box has got a couple frames in it, but if you look down in there, it's got all the backings from some pictures and all the glass. So I have a ton of like 8x10 glass pieces of glass. Down below there, that was that wine haul that I did. That was that stuff from a wine haul. Odds and ends from just different places. That's some, there's a set of wind chimes down there. You might have seen those. It's like, like I said, this is organizing time. There's a frame in here and some more glass. I'm saving all these glasses, pieces of glass, because I do have some frames back here. Some more Christmas stuff, some frames back here. Yes, we did find that stool. But just a few more Christmas things that I have to put away into a Christmas box. I'm not going to show you that. That's a surprise later. Some frames sitting back here. Some are missing glass. But most of them are, they're not broken. And they're really nice, heavy-duty wooden frames. This is also some stuff that I have just kind of slid underneath here. But this was from a Bath & Body Works haul. Lotions and just a ton of lotions. And you see down there, more lotions, bath bombs. Those things, not all of this. Oh, in fact, I need that. I've had a toothache lately. I got to get to a dentist. Don't know when I'm going to be able to, but I need this. So now I know where it is. And then this came out of a CVS. They squirted a bunch of oil all over it. Pantene shampoo and conditioner. Some Old Spice, whatever that is. A bunch of, I've given some of these away. Head and Shoulders Men 2-in-1 Old Spice. I've given a bunch of those already away. I don't even know what's in there. It was a nice case, I think, which, like I said, I don't know what even that is. That's about it for there. But, that's kind of, and you guys are probably going to go, oh my God, when you get back here. And that's fine because, like I said, this Saturday was supposed to be our flea market. And most of this stuff, it's going to be dark for a second. Oh, I'll show you the bike in a minute. This stuff back here was going with us to the flea market. And this has all been organized, all been gone through. And I have marked all the boxes on what is what. This was a haul from a Walgreens. I have given a lot of stuff away. Nerds, gummy bears. This is some protein. It is past the date, but it doesn't mean that it's not good. You know, Swedish fish, these sweet tart ropes, Lindor chocolates. Tons of those Hershey bars. I have a whole big box. It's in here somewhere, but these little Kinder Joys, I found a bunch separate, and I found a whole box. And you might have already seen this, but I don't know, a bunch of these Altoids, and there's more of the Kinder, that's all gum. So that's all organized. There's toys back there, more toys. This is like office supplies and folders for school, you know, your school folders. This is bags that has all charging cords in it. This is all my like electronics and stuff. That's all candy canes. And the expiration date, which is really funny on this stuff, and they don't even expire until like July. So I was all this stuff, and no, that's not trash. They wrote trash on it. All this stuff was going with us to the flea market. I have dog supplies. These are all USB cords that I was going to take. Oh, there's the actual box of the full box of Kinder Joys. They're not even open. These are some reptile lights. It's just ridiculous, the stuff I have. Some wrestling figurines. A bunch of tin letters that I found. In fact, this one I'm probably going to keep because that's me. And I'm sure there's a K in here. I'm pretty sure there was a K, so M and K. And a bag of yarn that I got to get sent off to my aunt. She makes mittens, and I'm sure you've probably heard me talk about that. These bins, like I said, everything. Oh, and then my boyfriend was just asking me about those. He says, where's those torque bits? This was a pretty good haul out of a Harbor Freight. Not all of it, obviously. Doggy booties. But he's keeping all these. These are all torque bits. Some of them are missing. Yeah, they spray painted them. Big deal. Big deal. Looks like there might be a frame in there. This is all some fasteners for an air gun. Oh, and then I found all these Himalayan coarse salt thingamajingies. What do you call those? Grinders. This was in I don't know where it came from. Could have been Bed Bath & Beyond. And yes, I have gift cards down there. Not sure what that was. We haven't figured that out yet. Ultimate Daily Vitamin Bites. Those look like they're licorice flavor. I haven't even opened them up. This was Christmas stuff from the Marshalls. And I remember the date because the date's on there, January 10th. And I spent over an hour and a half in their dumpster. And I swear to God, I had a ton of stuff. These are all like hot chocolate. And these are the ones I was telling you. The expiration date on these things isn't even until July. But there's chocolate coins, hot chocolate powder, and marshmallows. Also, there's a few other things. This is a whole box of posters that I pulled out. No, the matches back there. That's part of our stuff. And the headboard. It is for sale, but that's also part of our stuff. And that, well, let's move this so you guys can really get a good look. I don't know if anybody's on here. This is a motorcycle on there, but this is my boyfriend's chopper. Yes, it's in the house because we don't have a garage to put it in, and we didn't want it out in the weather. We have a building, but it's open on both ends. But that's the chopper that he built. Isn't she beautiful? And no, I don't ride on it. It's like riding a bull. I ride the Sportster he has, though. Okay, now we're going to go over. I'm going to push this back. There's more toys that I've pulled out. Light up, you know, headphones. Like I said, this whole side has been organized and was going with us this Saturday to the flea market. That's part of my wine haul. You guys have already seen a few other things. Over here, this is a baby swing. I've got to take the battery thing off and see if it, put the battery in, see if it even works. It looks brand new. It's like a $140 swing. I'm pretty sure this is the one my son has for son and daughter-in-law. Adam, oh my, that's a cute little rolling suitcase thingy for a little girl. And this is the stuff, sorry, that I have not quite organized yet. So I have to go through all this stuff. There's a humidifier, a blow dryer that I've pulled out. These are headphones in there. This is another, if you guys all like this stuff, not even going to attempt to say, because I know I'm just going to blow that. And then I've given quite a few of these away to people already. So this is just some of the stuff that I have in here that has to be gone through and organized. Some 4th of July headbands and stuff. It's ridiculous the amount of stuff that I have found. But like I said, don't look at me as like, oh my God, she's hoarding that stuff. No, I'm not. We were supposed to be doing a flea market Saturday, and all this stuff was going to the flea market. So it'll just be time spent. Oh, and this was that makeup haul that I believe I got at, this was all from Marshall's. Yep. And I believe I did a video on this, all this makeup. So I have to go through this. And that could be part of stuff that's given away too. Makeup. That could be another selection of, what you possibly could want as far as my giveaway whenever I hit that 1,100. I'll also do another one if I hit 1,000. But here's a couple other things that I have found. This is bath and shower gel. I don't know why that got thrown away, but here's another one. Milk Day. That's another body wash. Obviously got thrown away because that's smashed. I just put another one on there. Here is another one from Marshall's. Biotin Therapy Mill Creek Botanical Shampoo. Okay, we're going to walk over this way a little bit and show you a couple other things. I pulled this great big huge bouquet, as you can see. There is, let me count real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 of these. And they are $7 a piece. $56 worth of flowers. Nothing wrong with them. They were shoved in a bag over top of the, but there's nothing wrong with them. Look how pretty they are. They're beautiful. So I will be selling those. Also, everything you see back here, except for my plant that I have forgot to water, is dying. This is also stuff that I pulled out of Marshall's one time. These cute cups and stuff. These are little kids' safety glasses from Michael's. A bunch of those. This whole box down here, when I pulled it out, I was so excited because I thought it was going to be the cart. And it wasn't. Guess what it was? Here, I'll show you. It was all paints. Paints and paints and more paints and paints and paints. So if you have a kid, if you have a child, and I do a giveaway and you pick the child thing, they'll probably get some paints in there. I almost guarantee they're going to get some paints in there. A bunch of oddball stuff down there. Oh, and I found these 5 John Deere. They're a little, I got to clean them up. 5 John Deere tractor hats. Brand new. Look at it. They still have the thing inside and the tags on them. So I'm going to clean those up. This is not what I found. That's a bag of rags. But over here, I'm just going to quickly, there's a curling iron. That is another thing. That's a blow dryer. You know, the box of Kleenex is not something we found. A blow drying brush. There is a Christmas tree. It's broken. I don't know if I'm going to be able to repair it or not. This is also, these were tins that I found in Joann's. I think they're really cute. If you know what Walker's shortbread cookies are, oh my God, they're so good. We ended up eating them. So we ate the cookies. Sorry, but we ate the cookies. I'll probably just sell the tins. People love tins. So I know there's more stuff over here. I just don't know if I can get to it. My toilet seat. That actually is awesome, because we need an elongated one, and they're not cheap. Okay, let's see. I don't know if there's anything else underneath here or not, besides my Harley shirt. This was one of those spiral machines where you cut and make, like, veggies, spiral your veggies. The picture's not on there. I think you might be able to see what, you know, different things you can do. But it's called a spiralizer. And it, this is not a return or refurbished product. We are not radicals. Listen to this. This is not a return or refurbished product. No, we are not radicals, but we believe in 100% recycled products. Yes, we try to leave the smallest ecological footprint that we can. Yes, we make the best spiral slicer available and appreciate your business. Thank you for purchasing a Bitani eco-friendly product. Boop, boop. So it's like a vegetable spiraler, whatever. And this box, which this is all what I'm going to be going through later on, is just, yeah, the band-aids were found, but we are keeping those. Those were found in a dumpster. But this, if you have a, like I said, a kid and a child, and you and the drawing comes up, the contest, and you choose child, or if you yourself want any kind of crafting product, I have fabric markers, I have more colored pencils. This whole drawer, I believe, down here is full of markers, and as you can see, I started to already go through and organize some of them. These are all huge Sharpies. More markers and more markers and more markers, and I have more bins of these filled with markers. This was the Michaels, came out of the Michaels dumpster, where they dumped all their classroom product and probably just decided. But I've gone through and 90% of these markers work, so they're still good. That's my jacket. Didn't find that in the dumpster. Just other stuff. We'll go through real quick. Oh, yeah. See, there's so much stuff. Everything's just falling everywhere. That was a small little tarp. That was more stuff that I found in the Michaels dumpsters. These are felt and foam. And there's a sketch pad, and there's paper. So like I said, if you pick craft and you tell me you like to paint, you'll probably get some paints and a sketch pad. If you sew, and, you know, this is beading for to make necklaces. And these are a pineapple quilt. Joanne's cut up the books and threw everything in there, but these are the pineapple quilt template. And a bunch of those. Yeah, did you hear Kevin? Hey, where's my step stool at? Guess what I did? Last week, a Burlington dumpster dive, we found a great big huge industrial fan. And I'm going to turn you around. Big huge industrial fan, one of those big, big round ones. Well, while pulling it out, I had to get up on the step stool so that I could push it down where Kevin could pull it out. Guess what? After we lifted it in the truck, and it took us forever to get it in the truck because I had stuff in there, I left his three-step step stool at the dumpster. When we realized that I did that, went back, some lucky sucker got my nice step stool. Or should I say, Kevin's nice step stool. So I got to get a new three-step, you know, step stool thingy. So that's that. It most certainly was not. He said it was like $100. No, not. Anyways, here we go. With a few other things that... There's so much in here, I don't know what's in here. This is all craft stuff, yes, that I got out of Joann's. There's beads, and there's colored tape, and there's glitter, and there's some big bags of rocks, and more safety glasses, and some 50-piece neon bracelets. So, you know, some of this stuff. Oh, there's magnet, double-sided magnet, a whole roll of that. This is decoupage. You know, just tons and tons and tons of stuff. And down below here, these are bins of markers, you know, paint sticks. And there's more stuff, more craft stuff. So this is all crafting stuff. I'm not going to, you know, pull it all apart because there's just too much stuff and I don't want to. Oh, this was some cards and stuff that I'd gotten out of a dumpster, and a cute, these are cute little penguin wine stoppers. But that's it for in here for now. I'm going to set you down and I'm going to sit back down and talk for just a second. So my next video will probably be going through the sorry, I didn't know if I turned it off or not. Going through the trailer and showing you some of the stuff that I have found more recently, but was not able to videotape. We went out a while ago and found, actually we went out, I think it was last Saturday we went out, and we weren't planning on dumpster diving at all. We did what we had to do, and we decided, oh, hey, we're by a bunch of stores, let's go. So I didn't have anything with me, but I did find a lot of stuff, so I wanted to show you guys that. So with that being said, I am going to say peace. I love y'all, and please like, share, subscribe, hit the notification button, because if you hit the notification button when I post the video, when I reach 100 people and I post the video on doing the giveaway, you'll get that notification. So share with your friends, tell them to subscribe, tell them I've got a big giveaway coming up when I hit 100. It'll be well worth their time to do it. I can guarantee you. All right. Love y'all. Talk to you later. Peace. Stay safe. Sanitize your hands. In fact, that's what I'm going to go do right now, is put some hand sanitizer on it. None of this stuff has been in here. All this stuff has been in here for a while. Nothing's coming in the last couple of days. So but I still hand sanitize. So, bye.